हेलो दोस्तों, होप एवरीवन इज सेफ एंड फाइन। नाउ दैट द प्रीलिम्स इज ओनली 40 to 50 डेज अहेड, आई थिंक इट्स वेरी क्रूशियल टाइम दैट यू फोकस ऑन द रिविजन। सो हियर वी ब्रिंग यू अ कोर्स दैट एनहांसेस योर रिविजन पार्ट। सो वी ब्रिंग यू द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर्स टॉपिक्स फॉर द प्रीलिम्स 2020। सो माई नेम इज प्रताप रेड्डी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद द एनवायरमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी। राइट, लेट्स गो अहेड। So how does this course will help you, right? So I bring to you the most focus areas of the UPSC prelims. Like for every prelims test, there are certain areas in each subject in which the UPSC has a tendency to ask most of the questions. For example, it might be the conventions or any multilateral agreements. And this course will be a kind of a revision for you. How? For example, if I bring a current affair on a convention part, I will tell you what areas to be focused in that. For example, what are its members? Who are all its members? Are there any important declarations? Are there any recent conference of parties? And where did it take place, etc. Going ahead, we also deal with the important MCQs. And we'll be dealing with the practice MCQs in the UPSC format. I will be telling you like how to think like an examiner, like how how an examiner might give you a question, right? So regarding the same, I will tell you about the tick dumps. So these two things will be you will be understanding while you will be dealing with the practice MCQs, right? So let us go ahead and see the content for the day. So today we will be dealing with the international organizations and the conventions. So today we will be dealing with the Ramsar Convention, ARENA, that is the International Renewable Energy Agency, and the three Rio Conventions, that is the United Nations Convention on Biodiversity, Climate Change, and the Combat Desertification. Okay. So first one, the Ramsar Convention. So this took place in Iran. This is Ramsar is a place in the Iran, right? And it started in 1971. So officially it was known as the Convention on Wetlands of International Importance, especially as waterfall habitat, right? So the other way they call it is the Convention on Wetlands. So it came into force in 1975. So there is another important aspect regarding the same, that is the Montreux Accord. What does it say? So it registers the wetland sites of the wetlands of international importance. So what happening is like due to the human activities, there is a change in the ecological character. So is there any kind of threat to those kind of the wetlands which are of the international importance, right? So those things will be recorded in this report. So from India there are two, that is the Koilado National Park, that is in Rajasthan, and the Loktak Lake, that is in Manipur, right? And remember, this is an intergovernment organization and it is not a part of United Nations. So let us take one practice MCQ. So which among the following statements are true? So both Ramsar and Wetland International intergovernment organizations dedicated to conservation and restoration of wetlands. Second statement, Montreal's record is a record of wetlands which are undergoing ecological impact under Ramsar Convention. The third one, Koilado National Park and Loktak Lake are part of this record, right? So, see, what UPSC do is, they tend to change the nature of the organization. See, here we know that Ramsar is an intergovernmental organization, but see about the Wetland International. So, Wetland International is also an organization working on the wetlands, but remember, this is a non-profit organization and not an intergovernmental organization. So UPSC tend to change this kind of details, right? So obviously one is wrong, and as we see in ahead, yeah, two is right and three is right. See, so it's two and three. So what you have learned, so here we learned the dictum that the UPSC tend to confuse with the near facts, right? And while you are doing the revision part, please focus on the nature of organization. It's not about in environment subject, even if it comes under any economy apart, right? So focus on what kind of organization is it? Like it's an United Nation, part of a United Nation, or is an intergovernmental, or it's an NGO. For example, there are past questions like Doctors Without Borders. So even that question. So that question, the answer was nothing but an NGO, right? So focus on the nature of the organization. So the second is the International Renewable Energy Agency, IRENA. So recently there was one report, Renewable Power Generation Costs in 2018. So according to that, India is the lowest cost producer of solar power globally. So this is also important fact. So the second one is, if there is any kind of report, see where does India stand, right? And Canada is the highest one. And so IRENA, it is the first international organization exclusively focusing on the renewable energy. So if you see this, some fundamentals regarding the same, there are 180 plus countries in this, and it is an intergovernmental organization and not an UN agency. So India is one among the 33 permanent members, right? So its headquarters is in Abu Dhabi. And what are the reports it publishes? Global Atlas and Global Renewables Outlook. So, well, as I said, if you see any kind of agency or convention, you need to focus on what is India's role in that, and whether that kind of organization, like nature of the organization here, and where its headquarters, and what are its reports, right? So let us see one practice MCQ. The report Global Renewables Outlook is given by, as we seen, it is nothing but IRENA. So these are more of a finance fact oriented questions. So it's like aapko pata hai to pata hai, right? So let's go ahead. And remember, the recently from the past 3 to 4 years, you see UPSC tend to ask more questions on these kind of reports. Like for example, recently they asked about the report by World Economic Forum. About the global competitiveness report, and previously they asked about the IMF reports, right? So focus on these kind of areas. So the next area we will be looking about the United Nations 3 Rio Conventions. So this 3 has come from the 1992 Rio Summit. So what are those? They are nothing but the UNFCC, CBD and CCD. Right, so this one is related to climate change, the second is the biodiversity, and the third one is related to combat desertification. So let us go ahead and see one by one. So recently, the Conference of Parties, COP is nothing but Conference of Parties. So Conference of Parties occurs for any convention, right? So it happens, generally the people think it's only for UNFCCC. It's not nothing like that. So COP occurs for any convention. Right, so recently COP25 regarding the United Nations Convention on Climate Change has occurred in Madrid, Chile. It is otherwise called as the Blue COP. And what are the important outcomes of this? So there is one Santiago Network for Technical Assistance. So they have considered this. So what is the importance of this? So they between the member countries now they are building one network for the technical exchange, right? The second one, it is importance to finalize the rule book for the Paris Agreement. So post 2015, they were considering, so what are the rules and regulations that would be driving for the for achieving the Paris targets, that is the keeping the global temperature levels between 1.5 degrees to 2.2 degrees, right? And there was also focus on the loss and damage funds. See, we know that there is one term called as the historical responsibilities. This is very much important. So for those historical responsibilities, many developing countries believe that the developed countries has to support them, right? So that they also contribute to the climate change. And however, there was no conclusion on the climate market. Climate market is nothing but the carbon credits, how they are exchanging in the market, right? So it's not much clear yet. So the next convention is on the convention on biological diversity. So important points regarding it is like there are 20 Aichi targets, right? For example, there might be a question, Aichi targets are related to, right? So they are 20 in number. So these are nothing but they are focused on how to reduce the causes or the impacts on the biodiversity and how should be the contribution of each stakeholder. So there are such 20 targets. Regarding the same, India has taken up 12 such things, such targets from these Aichi targets, which are specific to India, right? And by 2020, so we need to update what is the status for the same. India continuously is giving a report on how it is progressing in the context of the Convention on the Biological Diversity. So India is the first five countries in the world and is first in the Asia to give so, right? And we also ratified National Biodiversity Act 2002, right? So here one important point is like we know that GEF, that is the Global Environment Fund, supports these three, UNFCCC, CBD, and on the combat desertification, plus Stockholm, which is on the persistent organic pollutants, and the Minamata Convention is on, it's on mercury, So let us go ahead and see the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. So this came in 1994. This is the only legally binding international agreement, right? Legally binding international agreement. This is very much important. Now, what does this do? So this focuses on the dry lands, light lands, which are very much vulnerable. Like this is vulnerable in the context of not only flora and fauna, but also the people who are dependent in those regions, right? So recently, the COP, the Conference of Parties of this particular convention, has taken place in New Delhi, right? The theme is the Restore Land, Sustain Future. So here they have taken up the Delhi Declaration, right? So here the participant decided to participate in the Peace Forest Initiative. So this seems to be very important. I will be discussing later. And apart from that, they promised to recovery of 5 million hectares of degraded land in India. And they also bought up this drought toolbox. See, UPSC want to ask this kind of questions. Like for example, in previous year questions they have asked about the WTO green box, like, right? So what is this drought toolbox? This is nothing but the knowledge repository to how to tackle a drought like conditions, right? So what is Peace Forest Initiative? This is an initiative by South Korea for the ecological restorations as a peace building process. So this is nothing but if there is any conflict zone, so that might be led to some kind of degradation, right? So here this is a kind of international collaboration to neutralize such degradation, right? And there is another initiative for sustainability, stability and security. This is launched by 14 African countries to address the migration driven by land degradation. And how they do, like they tend to focus on the improving the green belts. By improving the green belts, they want to increase the jobs there, right? So if we see on this kind of areas, we see that there are many previous year questions. For example, there was one question on the Biocarbon Fund initiative. Like this was given by the World Bank. And recently there was a question on Movement for Change, Climate Neutral Now. This was a UNFCCC initiative. Similarly, they asked one question regarding the ATHAR, which was given by WWF. So this is the initiative of the WWF. Okay, now let us see one more initiative, that is a Greenhouse Gas Protocol. So let us assume we don't know what exactly this Greenhouse Gas Protocol is. So I will be telling you one tip down, that is the how to deal with these kind of questions by using etymology. So here let us first analyze the options here. The first one says it is an international accounting tool for government and business leaders to understand, quantify and manage greenhouse gas emissions. The second statement says it is an initiative of United Nations to offer financial incentives to developing countries to reduce greenhouse gases emissions and to adopt eco-friendly technologies. See, it is a financial incentive. The first point is here, financial incentive, and it is like financial aid to greenhouse gases. So, see, first understand the word protocol here. Do you think, what does the generally word protocol stands for? It is generally like a rules or like a certain kind of targets or measurements, right? But this is like a financial mechanism, right? So this can't be true. Let us deal with the C. It is an intergovernmental agreement. Now it is saying intergovernmental agreement ratified by all the countries of the United Nations to reduce the greenhouse gas emissions to the specified levels by 2020. See here, if we know the basics, we know that there is only one such agreement which has got the ratification by all the countries, right? There is a Montreal Protocol on the ozone layer depletion, right? So obviously this is also not true. And the last option is it is one of the multilateral REDD plus initiatives hosted by World Bank. See, first, what is REDD? We know that this is a kind of mechanism where certain majority of the developed countries will be investing in the developing countries to increase the carbon sink in the developing countries and reduce their contribution to the greenhouse gases of developed countries, right? So and this is saying this is a multilateral. First thing, focus on this area. This is a multilateral. First thing is like between the developed and developing countries, and so this is more like a carbon, creating a carbon sink, that is a kind of creating a forest. So even this is not going with the word protocol. So obviously we have only one option, that is it is an international accounting tool which is very much close to the word protocol for the government and the business leaders to understand, quantify and manage greenhouse emissions. Okay, so while going back and practicing certain kind of questions, please see and apply these kind of dictums, and if you are able to solve, it's very good, right? So one practice question on the same. Peace Forest Initiative is in news recently. Which among the following are true regarding the same? It is an initiative as a part of REDD++ to increase the carbon sink according to Paris Agreement. NDC is like each country has their own contribution to the Paris Agreement, that is the NDC. Okay, let us assume, but we have already known that this is not an initiative of REDD+, right? So this is wrong. The second statement, it is an initiative of UNCCD to combat desertification. See, yes, we have seen this Peace Forest Initiative as a part of UNCCD, right? But the thing is, this is not an initiative of UNCCD, but is an initiative by the South Korea, right? So this is also wrong. It's a platform to foster international collaboration to combat land degradation in cross-border post-conflict zones, right? This is very much true. And even for the confusing, I gave one more option here. It is a peace initiative between North Korea and South Korea. It's like if UPSC tends to give the options very much close to the, you know, to the concept. So be careful while dealing with such kind of options, right? Okay, so what are the takeaways from today's class? Like, we have seen the important focus areas, like I brought you important current affairs in the environment part, and we also dealt with certain dictums, like how to deal with certain questions even if you don't know, like for example the etymology, right? And how UPSC tends to give the near facts in the options, right? And we also practice certain MCQs in the UPSC format, right? So we'll be dealing this kind of most important current affairs and the dictums, how to solve those MCQs in the prelims, right? So till then, take care. Bye.